Yo, what is up, guys, and welcome to another Wild Rift video. And this champion right here is a little bit of a secret sauce. I do have to say, the playstyle I'm about to show you guys in today's video is only really gonna work if you're already quite good at Ahri. If you're not already like very good at Ahri, I highly suggest you to check out some of my other Ahri videos where I'm a bit more beginner friendly perhaps, because in this video we're gonna be diving deep into Ahri, into how to properly play this champion, how to snowball like crazy with this champion. And the game that I have for you guys today is gonna be one of the craziest games you've ever seen as well. Just like the set game, you guys are gonna love to see this video. So, how do you build Ahri? The Magi Soul Stealer is the tricky part here, right? You can play Ahri without this item and you'll be fine. You can even build this item like after your Ludens Echo. You know, let's say you got a Ludens Echo, you're snowballing pretty well. You can then choose to go for the Magi Soul Stealer. If you're a Giga Chat Ahri, and if you kind of know the matchups, if you know you're gonna be fine, if you know you're not gonna die, you can go for the Magi Soul Stealer first item, gank quite aggressively, and continuously stack it up until the mid game where you're going to be absolutely unbeatable. The whole point of this item is for you to be unbeatable mid game. Even if you get to the later stages of the game, you know, and you lose some of these stacks, you're going to be okay. Like, you're going to get the value out of this item, because the whole thing of Ahri is she's quite strong early game, but her power lies in that mid game. And more on this during the gameplay. But yes, Magi Soul Stealer, Ludens Echo, Boots of Mana, and Rabadon's Deathcap are pretty much always going to be your first items. You can also go for the Crown of the Shattered Queen. You can go for this one to preserve your stacks more, you know, preserve your stacks, because this one is going to give you more sustainability. If you truly want to keep snowballing hard, then you go for the Rabadon's Deathcap, but you got to be more careful about your positioning if you go for the Rabadon's Deathcap. Either way, you're going to get either one of these items as your second or third or third and fourth item, and then as your last item, completely situational. I still love the Infinity Orb, even though this item has the flat magic penetration, which supposedly is an early game stat. Just the critical strike is so amazing on Ahri. Like, you know, you for finishing off enemies, you're gonna do ridiculous damage with this item. Like, it's actually crazy. And then you have all of these other extra items you can go for. You know, Riftmaker. I never go Riftmaker on Ahri, but I put it here. This one. It's funny about the Horizon's Focus. I never built this item, even though, like, it's actually quite good on Seraphine. It's quite good on Aurelion Soul. It's quite good on Seraphine. Supposedly, it could be good on Ahri. I don't know. I just don't really like how this item works, to be fair. This one, however, the Ocean, its Trident, is going to be extremely powerful on Ahri if you need it. Like, if you're against a Janna or a Karma, the Shield Shredding is going to be very, very strong. Because you do have single target abilities that are going to be able to proc it. Like, your third ability is a single target ability, and you'll be able to shred like big parts of their shields. This is an interesting one, the Awakened Soul Stealer. I don't know if I want to recommend you guys this one, because, like, sure, it's going to be very strong if you're snowballing, but if you don't snowball, you're going to be screwed, like really screwed. But theoretically, you could build it here. Like, you could build that item there and just keep on snowballing. It is going to be stronger, but it's just, honestly, it's too risky. Because, like, the payoff you get for it is not even that big. And for the enchantment that you want to go, Stasis, Protobelt, or QSS, depending on the situation. Stasis, if you need Stasis, of course, is generally going to be the best one. QSS, if the enemies have like an Ash, and you really don't want to get stunned by that Ash. Protobelt, if you want to dive deep into their backline without having to always waste your ultimate. Or if you even want to use your ultimate plus, if they have a Caitlyn, for example, because, like, you ult, Caitlyn is going to use her third ability. You can then instantly Protobelt to her and catch her anyways. Now, for the runes, you go for Electrocute. First strike, I've tried it. It's not bad, but it's like, Ahri is not a one-time burst damage. Ahri likes to do multiple point. How do I say this? Like, Ahri likes to do multiple instances of burst damage. And if you look carefully, cooldown 20 to 13 seconds. If you level up, the cooldown gets reduced. So in the late game, in a team fight, you can proc the Electrocute up to like 3 or 4 times. While the first strike, you're only going to be able to proc once in a fight. And you're not even going to do that much damage with it. So that's why, like, I don't really think first strike is going to be that good on Ahri. Electrocute is just going to be better. Here you go for the Domination Tree. I've tried Precision Tree. It's really not good, because you want to have this early game damage. I know a lot of Ahri players like to go Scorch. I go for Sudden Impact, because it just gives you bigger chunks of damage with your ultimate. You know, when you ult, you're all inning. Sudden Impact is going to be very, very nice with that. But if you just want to bully the enemy more in lane, Scorch is going to be better for you. My personal recommendation is the Sudden Impact. Here you go for cheap shot. Of course, whenever you impair their movement with your third ability, you're going to be doing a whole lot of extra damage with the cheap shot. It's quite good. I mean, if you're unable to hit your abilities properly, you can also go for Mark of the Week. The thing is, Mark of the Week does make a ton more sense on Ahri, because of course, cheap shot, you're kind of reliant on hitting your third ability. But Mark of the Week is probably the weakest rune in the game, hence the name Mark of the Week. Only weak people use this. This rune is not going to do anything. Like, for some reason, this rune is just completely and utterly useless and really doesn't do anything. So I just pretty much never recommend you to go for it. An empowered attack, it can be good. It's basically like a Scorch, but then Cheap Shot is going to do the true damage, which I love as well, because like, even in the late game, it can be quite useful where you're charming an enemy frontline. You'll do that true damage to them in addition to your first ability's true damage. Here, of course, we go for Eyeball Collector. This one will actually scale very beautifully into the late game. Here it's situational. There's two different runes I recommend. Actually, three. First one is Bone Plating. It's obvious bone plating is good if you need a bone plating. If you have like a Yasuo or a Zed, you want to have a bone plating against that. Second one I recommend is, not the Sweet Tooth, is the Transcendence. This one, if you want to spam your abilities more often, this one is going to be great if you don't feel like you need a bone plating. Third one is going to be a Giant Slayer. Of course, if the enemies have tanks. You really don't want to go for this one. But for example, if you first picked Ahri and they just picked all the tanks in the game, you're gonna be forced to go for Giant Slayer. Remember, you don't want to pick Ahri into tanks though. Yes, and for the spells you go for Flash and Ignite. So that is it about the build. Let's now get into the gameplay. Come on, click on the play button. There we go. Man, it feels so good. I feel like I got my voice back. My voice is kind of on like, I would say like 85%. It's still cracking a bit. It's still being a little bit annoying. But I haven't coughed a single time in this video yet. So I feel good. I feel very, very good. I want to remind you guys, by the way, I am doing a skin giveaway like always. The other person, remember yesterday I told you guys like someone claimed the skin. He had the exact same name as an actual winner. I checked it as well, and it truly was his YouTube name. And the original winner also claimed his skin. So there were three winners, but one of the winners, actually two people claimed the skin, and I gifted both of them the skin because I was like, it's unfair because like technically he won the skin, like the fake winner. But it was not actually him, because it was someone with a different profile picture. But then the person with the actual winner also contacted me, which is quite funny, actually. Because I get a lot of people trying to scam me with skin winners, but like this guy genuinely had the same name. It was actually funny. So yeah, just wanted to share it with you guys. Also, very interesting, the Teemo video I uploaded yesterday, only after a couple hours, it already reached like 800 likes. What is wrong with you guys? Why are you guys giving the videos so many likes? Like, I get it when I set goals for the videos. You know, I get when I say like, if this video reaches 1,000 likes, I'll upload a Jhin video or whatever. But like, the recent videos have also achieved 1,000 plus likes for no reason at all. I don't really get that. I'm extremely thankful for that because my YouTube channel has been doing incredibly well thanks to you guys. He's dead. He can flash, but I'm like, I wouldn't even flash after him. Smart of the Twitch to not flash, by the way, because he knew he would be dead anyways, and he knew I wouldn't even have to waste my flash. So pretty smart of him, actually. Easy kill right there. Just a little disgusting pick off on the enemy, right there. This game will be ridiculous, by the way. Like, especially, you're gonna wanna see the ending. I'm not gonna tell you for what reason. I'm just gonna tell you, you're gonna want to see the exact ending. The last second of this game. The absolute last second of the game is what you're gonna wanna see. Nothing else is gonna be shared about that part of the game. And if you don't wanna spoil yourself, do not look through the comments. Because I'm sure there's gonna be comments, you know, talking about the ending. Because of how ridiculous it is. So I suggest you to not check out the comments of this video. Only until like the very ending of the video. So what Baron is doing right here, the Twitch, he basically suicided under the turret on purpose, just to stack up his blue cane. Because he has that item, the burning item. So essentially he's kind of just running down the turret, just to stack up the item as much as he can. That is his idea right here. Because he wants to get that blue cane as fast as possible. Yeah, so you see that burning item there? So I went for the Magi Soul Stealer this game. Obviously now I have to play it a bit safer. Well, not yet actually, because I have zero stacks right now. But when I start to get when I start to get a couple stacks, I have to adjust my playstyle a bit. And this is where it becomes a bit interesting, because all my RE videos, I teach you guys about aggression, constant diving, constant boom, boom, boom. Now, on the other hand, you're still going to be constantly aggressive. However, this is early game, this is late game. During these stages, you want to be hyper aggressive, okay? Early, late game. Like right here, you see? I want to do this. Early, late game. I'm literally in the enemy jungle. Oh my god. Oh, baby. I only got one assist, but what I'm trying to say. These stages, you want to be super aggressive. Now, on the other hand, you see I have four stacks. This means we've approached the early mid game. Throughout the entire mid game, I want you guys to adjust your mindset on how to play RE with the Magi's Soul Stealer. I'm only talking Magi's Soul Stealer. If you do not build the Magi's Soul Stealer, of course, you can ignore this entire concept that I'm giving. So you see how I'm positioning myself, trying to be safe, but they're really desperately doing their best to kill me right here. I'm still dead. Like, I actually played it well, but they just used everything on me and killed me. I just lost my stacks. That is not good. But throughout this mid game, you want to play it in a calculated way. You want to play aggressive in a calculated way. You really, really want to do your best to not die. Okay? Which is an obvious thing to say, but you are never going to sacrifice yourself for an enemy. If you have like 20 stacks and an enemy has like a 700 gold bounty and you have the opportunity to kill that enemy and die for it, you're not going to take that opportunity. But hells, how does that make sense? Let me tell you how that makes sense. You are losing 50 ability power on that. Actually, not necessarily 50. You're losing 6. Sorry, you're losing 30. Because you're gaining 4 stacks and you're losing 10. If you're gaining 3... Is it 4 or 3? I know with ranged champions you gain 4. So you're essentially losing 6 stacks. You're losing 30 ability power. 30 ability power is worth like what? Like 600 gold? Something like that? So you see what I'm saying? You're getting a 700 gold bounty. But you're losing 600 gold for it. So... like 600 gold worth of items. But of course, if the bounty is 1000 gold, it's a different story, right? And it's also a different story whether you're 100% able to get the kill. Because let's say you can 100% get the kill. Then maybe you could go for that little bounty right there. If it's not 100%, you're not going to go for it. I mean, look at this, by the way. I just completely cleaned up their entire team right there. I literally just ran them down. Now I'm on 12 stacks. So now the caution will begin. Also, I forgot to say, you're not only losing ability power. If you get below 10 stacks of the Magi's Soul Stealer, you're also losing that invaluable 10% movement speed, which is also worth probably around like 700 gold, maybe even more. So like, you're losing so much. You're not only losing the AP, which is worth a lot of gold, you're also potentially losing the movement speed, which allows you to constantly traverse through the map. Like, I want you guys to look at how fast I am. Look at how fast I am. Look at how fast. I'm gonna flash my charm here to catch that Nami, but it's actually kind of risky. I got my stacks and I'm running. Oh, I need to dodge everything. I need to run away while the... I'm dead. This is what I mean. This is why I chose this game, you see? So, like, sure, I killed the Nami. But, like, let's ignore the fact that Kai'Sa and Janna died for it. Let's say they didn't die for it. Even then, it wouldn't have been worth it. So you see what I'm saying? It's not worth for me to be aggressive under their turrets right there. Because we got collapsed on. And I literally just lost. I lost like a ton of ability power. And I lost the movement speed bonus. I do not have the movement speed bonus now. So it's... You see, like, you don't want to play like this. You don't want to play like what I'm showing you guys in the video right here. But why am I showing you guys this video then? You'll see. Because while I'm making mistakes, it's going to get a whole lot better as well. A whole lot worse. A whole lot of everything. We have everything in this video. Again, I'm trying to talk without spoiling. That's the whole thing. So right here, Nami is a free kill. I'm rotating to potentially pick off that kill. And it seems like... that is so sad. That was... I'm playing it wrong, you see? I'm playing Ahri like you should play her with only a Luden's Echo, without the Magi's Soul Stealer. And again, I want to show you guys this video to show you what's wrong. Like, this is wrong. You guys remember, I had 14 stacks. I was extremely powerful. I had 14 stacks of the Magi Soul Stealer. And now I'm sitting at zero. Now we're back to square one. And now I gotta be careful again. Because now I just lost all my power. How the hell am I gonna make the comeback? See, the beautiful thing about Ahri is, let's say you are not carrying the fight, but like one of your teammates is very good and he's carrying the fights. You as an Ahri can very easily still secure yourselves a ton of assists. Let's say my Kayn goes in. I can simply ult, because your ult will bounce damage to everyone. Just make sure I get close to everyone. As long as I just do damage to everyone, anyone that is gonna die is gonna give me an assist, which means two stacks of the Magi Soul Stealer. So I can very easily, like at the very least, give myself stacks, especially with the Luden's Echo, by the way. That's why Luden's Echo is also especially good. This should be a kill for me. I'm trying to ult away, yeah. See, I'm playing like this now because I do not have any stacks of the Magi Soul Stealer. That's why. I actually went for Infinity Orb second item. Third item, I should say, because the Magi is the first one. And against squishy enemies, I actually do recommend the Infinity Orb second. Like this particular game, this is why I told you, like, there's a lot of situational builds as well. I just told you guys about the main build. And generally, I do not recommend the Infinity Orb as your third item. I always recommend it, like, get it, like, later on Ahri. But in this particular game, against a ton of squishies, they have zero tanks. I want to demolish them. I want to one-shot them. So I am getting an Infinity Orb third item. I'm gonna be utilizing the magic penetration that I get from it. I will do ridiculous amounts of damage with it. I could have gone for Crown of the Shattered Queen. Would have been very, very good against Twisted Fate. You know, for his ultimate to not reveal me. Or for his gold card to not stun me or anything like that. But then again, I chose for Violence this game. Because I lost all my Magi Soul Stealer stacks already. See, this is awesome. Oh, God. I cannot hear the game anymore. Okay, I cannot hear the game anymore. Hopefully I didn't break my earphones. I think you guys can hear the game. Let me just check. Yeah, okay, you guys can hear the game. What just happened here? What did I miss? I want to rewatch it because I completely missed the whole fight. Because I... Let's just take a look at what happened. Zero stacks of Magi Soul Stealer. Yeah, so what I was saying is I went Infinity Orb because I have zero stacks anyways. There's nothing to protect. If I had 20 stacks, I would have gone for Crown of the Shattered Queen now. But let's see what happens this fight. So Kayn dies. Oh, what? This is going to be an insane flank for me. Look, I hit everyone right here. That's one kill. That's two kills. I got like... What did I even... How do I still... Oh, I got a kill after dying. That's why I'm sitting at four stacks. Okay, that's actually quite interesting. So like if you ignite an enemy... I knew about that. I'm saying quite interesting as if I didn't know about it. But it's another thing, a little bit of a cheeky thing you can do. Like if an enemy is about to die, you can just ignite them. Even if you die and your ignite kills them after. Even if you lose all your stacks, you're going to get those four afterwards anyways. Which can be very good if you're sitting at a low amount of stacks. Because, like, let's say you get two kills and then you die, you literally lose everything. But if you get one kill, die, and then your ignite gets another one, you're gonna get the four stacks. I can get my Infinity Orb though. Oh, the enemies have an insane engage, but the Janna has an even more insane ult. Ooh, beautiful hit on the Twisted Fate. I'm actually really lacking damage right now. You can clearly see. I am lacking damage. This game is not going well. You guys are not gonna believe what's gonna happen this game. Ooh, my cat! Wow! What is that damage? I just destroyed them. You need to not forget that as an Ahri, you will demolish squishies. Look at that, even Janna's like, oh my god, this Ahri is so good. Oh. Yeah, so I actually straight up skipped the Crown of the Shattered Queen. I wanted to go full balls deep engage. Like, I wanted to just go full damage. Because again, I'm not sitting on a lot of Magi stacks. So I just want to go ham on them. I'm flash combing on him. Hopefully I can kill him with the Janna. There we go. 16 stacks of the Magi Soul Stealer. See, now we're actually getting somewhere. And another lesson I want to give you guys with this video is a lot of people start to rage when they die early game and lose their Magi Soul Stealer stacks. And while it's not ideal, the game is not over at all. Magi Soul Stealer can very much be a mid and late game item as well. Like, you remember how many times I died early game? I literally have 6 deaths. But yet I'm still sitting at 16 stacks right now. And it's going to be even like 20 stacks right now.
24 stacks. You see what I'm saying? You can totally get back your Magi stacks and it will snowball out of control. Like right now I'm sitting at 24 stacks, 24 times 5. Well, that's like 120 extra AP. 562 AP is what I'm sitting on right now. 562. And if I get that Ravenel's death cap, it's going to be like 800, even 900 AP. Like that's how crazy it gets if you're able to stack it up, even in the later stages of the game. So like you shouldn't be devastated if you lose the stacks early game. Of course it's not ideal. I'm not trying to sugarcoat it, but it's okay. Like I do not want to show you guys an ideal game. Because we all know what happens if you go 9-0. Obviously you're running them down with 30 stacks on Magi Soul Stealer. But what if you don't? What if you lose the stacks early game? You try to There goes 10 stacks. But then again. Humans make mistakes, but it's okay. You can recoup on those mistakes. And you can be fine. You can be okay. Like, I'm still strong here. As long as you're... Like, honestly, about the Magi Soul Stealer, as long as you're above 10 stacks, you are going to be okay. You're getting immense value out of the item. Anything above 10 stacks, you could pretty much consider as a bonus. Because above the 10 stacks is where you're getting the movement speed. And that's honestly the main thing. Well, of course, the damage is the main thing. But the movement speed really makes a difference. Look at this. I have 783 ability power. Even after dying. Before I died, I had 850. Because of the Ravenel's death cap as well. So, like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm still huge. I'm still very much powerful. And I want your mindset to also be like, you shouldn't get devastated too much when you lose those stacks. It's okay. It's going to happen. Not every game you're going to go 10-0. Obviously, you're going to die. And Magi Soul Stealer, you're still fine even if you die. The whole thing is, of course, what you do afterwards. Like right now, if I die again, of course, it's a problem. I'm going to start losing a lot of damage. And I'm going to start falling behind. But right here, he should be a free kill. Oh my god. I'm dashing away from TF right here. I'm just demolishing them right now with the big damage. I have another dash. I can charm him. He actually flashed out of the charm. But I did huge damage to the TF. TF died as well. And we're back at 24 stacks. You see? The beauty of the Magi Soul Stealers, as long as you're above 10 stacks, you're truly gonna do crazy amounts of damage. Like you're really gonna do huge, huge damage compared to other items. It's gonna feel unfair. But of course, if you're under the 10 stacks, that's where you're going to feel like this item is completely useless. And that's the thing about this item. Basically, between the 10 and 20 stacks, you want to be more careful. Now I'm at 26. And I honestly would even say that now when we've reached the super late game, you want to make the plays again. You want to dive deep again. You want to take more risk again. Because even if you die, you're going to be reset back to 16 stacks, right? Or 11 stacks, 12 stacks, whatever. You're going to be above that 10, okay? That I want you guys to have that in your mind. Because you don't want to play Ahri safe. Of course, if you play Ahri safe, what the hell are you going to do with Ahri when you play safe? The only reason you were playing sorta safe in the mid lane is to just make sure you get up the Magi Soul Stealer above 10 and maintain the stacks above 10. My team is dying. Oh my god, my team just gave up. Everything. All of them just died for a useless dragon. Why did they? I'm really not sure why they died for a completely and utterly useless dragon. We could have just given up the dragon and went for Baron. Now all of them died. I'm gonna try to bully them on this Baron, but I don't think I can stop it. I'm gonna, like, right here I tried to hit the Jhin with a charm. I missed, so I'm going out. Yeah. Oh my god, I'm not going out. What am I doing? Okay, that's just ending. I have no explanation for that one. Honestly, what I tried to do, my mindset, I thought I could kill someone very quickly. But Twisted Fate had his gold card ready. The thing is, if I killed someone, of course, I could have used my ultimate to run out. But the risk for this, like, there was maybe like a 20% possibility for this to work. I have no idea why I took that risk. Because now I, of course, did lose my stacks for no reason whatsoever. Again, we're still above that 10 stack threshold. But that was just dumb. That was just a dumb move for me. Completely stupid. Like, really no... Oh, now my team is fighting without me. But that's my fault. I should not have died right there. For no reason. Well, I just jumped over the Baron thinking I could get a kill quick enough to just jump back out of the fight. Very, very stupid of me. Very interesting to rewatch my own gameplay. Like, I'm so stupid sometimes. Oh my god. Here's where the game takes the interesting turn, by the way. You know, obviously they took the Baron. We were demolishing them throughout the whole game. Now we're losing, right? Like, what is gonna happen? What is happening? We're losing. Well, look at what I'm about to do. I don't even remember what I did, but I'm gonna try to assassinate them right there. And the thing about Ahri is, I'm QSSing her just to make sure, by the way. I would have died if I didn't. I just ulted, because, like, that Jhin, oof. I can catch Twitch here, maybe? There he is. Yep, very nice. I knew he was wandering around somewhere here. And we're back to 20. You know, we're back to 20. We're nice and safe still. They're trying to end the game. Okay, the Baron ran out. Dear God. That Baron did not run out. Right there, we would have just lost the game. I swear to God. Aw, come on. Okay, nice. I'm alive. Dying right there would have been detrimental, though. Even though I would have stayed above 10, it would have been detrimental because the Elder Dragon is up. But my king just died, which is horrible. Very close to my last item, by the way. Hopefully I can get a kill right here. I can flash charm the Jhin here. Am I gonna do it? But like, I want you guys to see how important the movement speed from the Magi Soulstealer is. Like, I'm literally able, like, look at how easily I can catch up to him. He did kill me though, but like, look at how easily I'm catching up to all of them. I should go for the crown of the Shattered Queen. Wait, when did I play this game? I think I played this game at a moment where I didn't know the crown was broken. Because I played this game like a while ago. I think I played this game like right after the patch. Because like, here I didn't know how broken the crown was yet. Yeah, I actually remember because I played this game right after the patch got released. I still have a lot of videos for you guys. So this one I played a while ago. Obviously I should have gone crown, right? But like, I didn't know yet here that the crown was going to be that broken. Telling them here to not die. Just telling them, the way we win this game is if we just fight together. We just need to fight together, we're going to be A-okay. I chose to go for anti-heal, which is actually also a good item. Because the Jhin has a bloodthirster, he's going to heal like crazy. Yone has a lot of vampirism, Nami has healing, so I want to have a lot of anti-heal. They're fighting without me though, but like, I can one-shot him here. There we go, he's one-shotted. I'm dead. The tide is not in my hands anymore. Oh my God. They actually started the fight without me, which ended up being a horrible mistake. The enemies just took the Elder too, oof. Oh no. By the way guys, I want to remind you guys to like the video if you're enjoying it. If you haven't already, you can give it a like if you want to. Baron is desperately trying to defend here. Whoa, that should be a kill. No way. Okay. Wait. It's game over. We lost the game. We lost. Just like that, we lost. Damn. That was an ending that you guys probably did not expect. We lost. We just lost. That's okay. How much damage? I did 45,000 damage. I want to say I threw the game. Like, I could have played this so much better. But like, imagine if you are a good Ahri and you do not make these absolute idiotic mistakes that I made. You can absolutely hard carry games in the current patch right now. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this interesting video that I made today. I will see you all in the next Wild Rift video. Bye bye.